Welcome to our first episode of Solar System for All. Let's increase our scale and talk about some strange places in our solar system. The first place, obviously our sun. You all know this is a star, the source of all energy on Earth. But do you know how it was created? How does it generate its enormous energy? How will it die? We will know all of it in our first episode of this series. So stick to the end, please subscribe to our channel. Press the bell icon to get notified about the next episodes. Now let's start. To cut the long story short, the diameter of the sun is 109 times the Earth. That is, almost 109 Earths can be placed side by side along the sun's diameter. Almost 2.3 million Earths can be accommodated inside the volume of the sun. According to the size, it ranks in the top 10% of stars in our galaxy. There are huge amount of gas clouds roaming here and there in the universe. These are called nebula. These nebula are the nurseries of the stars. If you spin a dough very fast as it gets flattened, the same happened with the gas cloud. It gets flattened as it rotates. Now gravity comes in, drawing all the elements and concentrating those at one point. Most of them are hydrogen and helium. Rest are the remnants of other dead stars. As they are concentrated, temperature increased and sun took its baby cry in the womb. It took almost 50 million years for the sun to go from childhood to its adulthood. An initial boost due to the huge temperature at initial stages provided the energy to fuse two hydrogen atoms and convert it into helium. For this, some amount of mass is lost. That lost mass gets converted into energy. And this energy is equivalent to detonating 400 nuclear bombs each second. That is more than huge. The energy is so much that at this much distance away from the sun, you can still feel the heat. From core to the surface, light particles take almost 0.1 million years, whereas it takes only 8 minutes to go from sun's surface to Earth. That means the light, what you are seeing today, might have generated when first human appeared in Africa. The surface is called photosphere, then comes chromosphere. Unlike the lower layers, here temperatures get increased as you go away from the sun. Then the outermost layer, corona. This is a very thin layer, can be seen during total solar eclipses. Sometimes you have heard of the term solar wind, which can interrupt all the electronic gadgets and also the whole communication system. That's because of corona mass ejection. What is this? Due to the motion of charged particles, magnetic fields are generated at places. The charged particles then follow the fields and create big loop-like structures. Through the bigger ones, one to two Earths can easily pass at the same time. If such two loops get hit by each other, the charged particles there are thrown away to the outer space, making this solar wind that can harm any electronic device on Earth. Though there are different types of solar winds or storms, we will discuss it later. Also, you can see sunspots, which are less heated areas than the surroundings, thus generating fewer amounts of photons and being dimmer. The sun is balanced by two forces, outward force due to the fusion and inward pull of its own gravity. As the sun gets aged, after almost 5 million years, when the sun will finish all its hydrogen, it will start to burn its helium and fuse into oxygen and carbon. After almost 100 million years, it will finish all its helium, then at the core, oxygen and carbon will remain. At the surface, it will still burn its helium and start to expand. Only surface will expand like a shell, and due to the gravity, that core will collapse. As it expands, the surface temperature will get decreased and it will get reddish. The size of the sun will be 200 times today's size and probably will touch the Earth's orbit. The core will be of the size of Earth with half mass of the sun.
This is called the white dwarf. One spoon amount of that object will weigh about 13,600 kilograms.
With this, let's end it here. Let us know how much you like this video in the comment section. Please subscribe us for the upcoming videos in this series. Like, comment, share. Let's meet in the next video. Until then, keep knowing, keep informing. Goodbye.